In chapter 16 of Invisible Man, the narrator travels with Brother Jack to the Brotherhood rally to give his first speech. Now in the dressing room, the narrator notices a photograph of a boxer who lost his sight, reminding him of a story his father told him of also being beaten blind in a fight. This makes the narrator increasingly sad and anxious. The narrator stares at his legs, clothed in his new blue trousers, ruminating on how these legs have carried him throughout his life, and now on this new road as part of the Brotherhood. Finally, it's time to give the speech. As the narrator walks out, the spotlight temporarily blinds him and he falls. He can no longer see the audience. He starts off nervously, but applause kicks in his adrenaline. In all the excitement, the narrator forgets the freshly learned phrases of the Brotherhood and decides to just rely on his instinct and go with his gut. He gives a passionate speech about dispossession, using an analogy of a man throwing stones at a pair of one-eyed men. The one-eyed men blame each other because in their partial blindness, they don't see the third man. The narrator tells the audience to work together, unified, to fight against dispossession. As his speech crescendos, the narrator begins to weep, overcome with emotion and driven on by the crowd, though he cannot tell if some are heckling or cheering him. The narrator feels the speech is an overwhelming success. The Brotherhood, however, is sharply critical, calling the speech dissatisfactory, hysterical, irresponsible, incorrect, backward, and reactionary, and most of all, unscientific. He is sent to see Brother Hambro, essentially an education coach for the Brotherhood's agenda. Nevertheless, the narrator is proud of what he said and of the connection he felt to the audience and the black race. This chapter is yet another full of references to blindness, eyes, and thinking clearly, linking the theme of vision to the narrator's quest for identity. In his speech, the narrator suggests that blindness to each other's realities pulls a society apart, like the pair of one-eyed men blaming each other on the street. Characters in Invisible Man blind themselves to the individuality of those around them to protect their personal gains. The narrator sees that for an entire community to be elevated, everyone must work together. The speech rallies the audience into an excited frenzy, ready to take action, presumably the goal of the Brotherhood. Thus, the narrator is shocked when the Brotherhood claims his speech was a disaster. They are only interested in progressing the organization's politics, not in truly uplifting the community. Brother Hambro, which will no doubt be similar to the white is right education he received in college, is going to coach him in this ideology. This chapter is also filled with foreshadowing. The narrator doesn't yet understand that the organization is using him as a figurehead, not wanting his individual thoughts, emotions, and talents. The other daydream the narrator has about the man with the disfigured hand hints at the decay of the narrator as a kind of hand of the Brotherhood. Soon, the narrator will sacrifice even more of his personal identity in pursuit of his dreams.